And I realized that the good thing is you actually don't have to trade too many things. Mm. Yeah, more important is you master something and you become consistent in it. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Philip Teo, your host for Online Trading Summit, and I'm excited to introduce to you Kathleen Toh, our presenter for this session. Kathleen is the founder and chief coach of Beyond Insights. She's also a professional trader who earns her wealth from investing and trading in the US and global equity markets. Beyond Insights has been awarded Malaysia Top Financial Trading Company in Malaysia by the Top 10 magazine. And Kathleen has also been nominated for Great Women of Our Time by the Women's Weekly in 2013 for the Finance and Commerce category. Over the past few years, she has also coached and trained more than 4,500 investors and traders to teach them how is the best way, the best practices and the strategies to actually trade the market based on their personality and lifestyle.
So this is a table. It may take some time to digest. Okay. This is the compounded return, but there's a clause here. You can only achieve this when you're competent and disciplined. Okay. Beginners usually will not be consistent that fast. It takes a few years, yeah, typically 2 years and beyond, in order to be very consistent in trading. Okay. So make sure that you have the realistic expectations, right? Don't go for, you know, some seminar they may be sharing with you, wow, you can make money very fast, or this person make money in 3 months, in 2 months, and then you start to have the wrong expectation that you can do that too. It's simple to make some quick bucks, right? It doesn't mean you cannot make money in the first few months, right? You can even get lucky in your first trade and you make money, right? But what I mean is consistently have confidence in your strategy that you can repeat the success. It takes a lot of practice, okay? Yeah, so but when you are willing to put in the practice, same like any profession, right? It could be you are a lawyer or doctor, you are a programmer, right? It takes a few years, so have the right expectation. But when you have the right practice and your discipline, this is the return you can expect.
How do you actually handle the market at the start of the year when things was looking so good, looking so fantastic, going to all-time high, and suddenly it plunged very sharply within just 1 to 2 months, recovered very strongly, and continued to see some kind of very volatile movements even towards the last few months of the year? What was your general strategy in terms of approaching the US market during this entire year?
Oh yeah, I think the most important is know when to cut loss, okay? So I always have a cut loss point. For my investment, I always have a hedging against the QQQ, yeah, which is the technology index. But let's say for a most simple newbie, right, what they can do is to make sure that, let's say they are doing trend trading, right? They always move up the stop loss on the way up. Right? When there's a new support, right, find a new support, move your stop loss up. Find a new support, move your stop loss up. So when the market turns, automatically you will be up. Yeah, you don't have to be watching it. In fact, if you're watching it, it's worse. Like you don't want to get up. Okay? You will be hoping, right? Yeah. So then there's a methodology to know when it's safe to get back in, right? So there's so when you break that support and the trend line, you get up, right? So then if it continue to come down, you don't get in back until it stabilizes on the strong support. And for beginners, I ask them to look for a higher low and a higher high confirmation, right? And moving going back above the moving average before they go in.